Hi everyone, today we'll be having fun with Stefari, talking about different groups and playing together, talking about bass and drums. My name is Henrik Temesgan and this is my practice room. So Stefari, welcome. Today I'm thinking, maybe for the benefit of some of the musicians watching this program, we talk about the rhythm section. So maybe when we say rhythm section, we are talking about drums, bass, maybe percussions, keyboard could be a rhythm section or guitar. Mm-hmm. So, but the bass and drums are at the center of the rhythm section, I think. Mm-hmm. I always tell my students, if the bass and drums are tight, then the music is going to sound good. Whatever you put on top will be okay. Mm-hmm. But they're the foundation, I think, right?
Exactly.
And what do you think on this topic?
I mean, you're right. Drums and bass are the foundation of the music. Everything else, like, you know, piling up on top of them.
It's the cream on top of the cake.
Exactly.
So today I'm thinking maybe we'll demonstrate playing different grooves. There's so many grooves, but we'll take a few mm-hmm. and talk about that. So for example, the way I look at it, from my point of view, you could anytime add your opinion, Stefari.
Right.
So let's start with a 4-4 sort of funk group.
Mm-hmm.
So what we'll do is first you play any funk group that you want.
Mm-hmm.
So I have to listen to the group that you play, and I'll try to play something that sits tight with that group.
Mm-hmm.
So something that sounds good.
Okay.
And I'll explain, there's two ways of doing it for me.
Mm-hmm.
So. For me, what I'll do is, the first way I'll do it is, I'll listen to your kick drum.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe we should talk about the drum set first. What instrument is what, which the tom-tom, the hat, the different parts of the drum set, maybe you can talk to the audience.
Okay, like you said, the bass drum is the foundation of the rhythm. So this is the bass drum. So when you play the drum, mostly, like, it doesn't matter what type of music we're playing, the bass drum is the center of the rhythm that keeps the basic notes or rhythm on the music. And the snare and the hi-hat are like on the clapping, on the like a dancer clapping. So one.
According to the backbeat.
Backbeat, exactly. Yeah. So the other ones are like, you know, just putting like some extra stuff on it. Like, especially for if you're playing Latin music or African music, we use a lot of toms. So those are like extra stuff.
So now that Stefari has explained all the different parts of the drum set, I'm playing a 6-string bass today. Usually bass, typical bass is a 4-string bass with EADG strings, but I have a low B and a high C, but I have detuned my bass a whole step. That's a whole different story. But right now we're gonna play a groove. Stefari, if you can play any 4-4 groove, sort of a funk groove. When we say 4-4, we're talking about, I don't wanna be too technical, but it's like a 4-4 time signature, a quarter note to every pulse or every beat. There's four of them in one bar. So there's million ways of combinations of playing a 4-4 beat, right?
Yes.
So it could be anything. It could be any groove within a 4-4 feel. Straight 8 notes, that's a fun groove.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll listen to what Stefari plays. He will play anything that comes to his mind in 4-4. And from there, I'll try to play. Too much is kick drum. That's a good way to start for beginner bass players. Try to do what the kick drum is doing and start from there. So let's do that first.
All right. Okay. 1, 2, 3.
So Stefari will be playing a 4-4 groove. I'll count it for you. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. So that's the basic pulse. And then I'll listen to the kick drum. It goes boom, 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 boom. So that's a good starting point as a bass player. So here we go. Now, once I play that, I can add in notes in between to make it more busier and more interesting. Mm-hmm. That would be a basic 4-4 groove. So what I was trying to do was match my bass line to the kick drum. So that's a good place to start. But that's not the only way to play. There's many ways of playing. I can still lock in with the drum set without matching the kick drum. So I'll play around, I'll dance around the kick drum and not actually exactly play what he plays, but still groove. So let's do the same groove again and I'll try to play something else.
One, two, three.
The original groove. So there is many ways of doing it, but the most important thing for me, Tefer, is that we lock somehow. So subdivisions are very important. Maybe we could talk about subdivisions, Tefari.
Yeah, I mean, like you said, you mentioned most of the stuff. So when you have subdivisions, like it will make the groove more interesting, like you said, like dancing around the rhythm. So you can use the exact downbeat or the upbeat. So make the album make it more interesting. For example, one, two, yeah, subdivisions are the main part of the music.
When we say subdivisions are the smaller divided beats between the beats. To explain it better, for example, if Tefari can play a quarter note for me on the kick drum at a slower tempo, and I could divide it into 16 notes if I want, so to practice. Or first, let's start with 8 notes, easier.
All right.
So 8 notes will be, so that's the kick drum. So if I play 8 notes, I'll play this on the bass. First quarter notes. Those are the quarter notes. 8 notes. And then I can play 8 note triplets. And then I can play 16 notes. Now the subdivisions is for every quarter note beat, I'm playing for 16 notes. So a good practice for musicians will be to play all the different 16 notes with the drum. So first I'll play on the downbeat, 3, 4, 1. And now I play the second 16 notes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. The third downbeat, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. The last. So this is a good practice to do that. So when I play, if Tefari plays a funk groove, now I can subdivide the 16 notes and play all kind of different 16 notes. Let's play this a funk groove. So this is the quarter notes are here. Do any kind of subdivision between that groove, so that will help for me to groove. So as long as I do that, then the part is gonna groove. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Tefari. So maybe for this lesson we'll do another rhythm, one more rhythm.
Okay.
So you pick one, Tefari. Any other rhythms other than 4-4 maybe?
How about 6-8?
6-8 sounds good. We could do the Ethiopian Chikchika 6-8, mm-hmm. or any other 6-8. We could do so. So you play it and then I'll start to count it for our audience.
All right. 1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, that's the sixth set. So I'll try to play with that. Thank you, Tavari. So the sixth eighth, the subdivision on the sixth eighth is there is six eighth notes, right, to each bar, mm-hmm. right?
Yes.
So again, it's a good practice will be to play the different subdivisions. As Tavari plays it, I will try to play it. Maybe slower a little bit.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 2, 3, 4, 5.
That's the six sets. I think that's good for today, Tavari. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And then we'll do another one for the next episode. Thank you very much for staying with us. We'll see you next week.